It used to be that Earth was largely seen as nothing particularly special in the days before the existence of exoplanets had been confirmed. While we knew nothing about exoplanets, the general consensus was that there was no reason for analogs of Earth to not be very common in the universe at large. But as we've learned more about exoplanets and the planets of our solar system, it seems increasingly likely that Earth is an exceedingly rare type of planet. At first, this may seem counterintuitive. After all, early in this solar system's history, it hosted three very similar worlds with liquid water present on their surfaces, but only one world, Earth, kept it long enough for an intelligent civilization to arise. Venus, on the other hand, went into a runaway greenhouse effect, losing its water, and Mars was simply not large enough to maintain a long-term ocean. This brings exoplanets into question. Unless they have exactly the right conditions to maintain liquid water long-term, then intelligent life seems unlikely to have time to develop on those worlds. But there may be more factors at play that might also determine the outcome of life on an exoplanet. One of those could be the presence of a large moon. One thing that may make Earth a rare type of planet is that we have a really large moon, one of the largest in the solar system, so much so that it's been suggested that the Earth-Moon system might better be classed as a double planet, and the circumstances of just how our moon came about sets it apart from the origins of any other object in the solar system. Scientists think that the moon was born when a roughly Mars-sized object collided with proto-Earth early in the solar system's history in a kind of glancing blow. The forming moon happened to settle in an orbit that stabilizes Earth's spin, but also caused tides to occur, which may have affected the development of life on Earth, though the specifics of that are unknown. But there is something else at play here, plate tectonics. Plate tectonics on Earth are somewhat of a mystery. It appears that it's probably a phenomenon associated more with larger planets, and Earth is borderline, and that may only be because of this planet's abundant water. In contrast, Venus does not currently appear to have plate tectonics, however, even though it's comparable to Earth in size, though it's possible it may have had it in the past when it's thought to have had liquid water as well. Without plate tectonics, Earth would look very different, perhaps a water world with only occasional volcanoes breaking the surface, but it might also be a lifeless world because of the lack of a carbon cycle. This may mean that habitable exoplanets with liquid water oceans are commonly super-Earth water worlds and that true analogs of Earth are very rare. This solution to the Fermi paradox has interesting implications. If the presence of plate tectonics and a large moon formed through a specific kind of collision are necessary for life to achieve intelligence, then civilizations would be extremely rare, but ocean worlds wouldn't be, providing plenty of chances for oceanic life to arise. While it's debatable whether oceanic life can ever achieve high levels of intelligence and civilization, Earth does provide some clues. On the one hand, most of Earth's oceanic intelligence comes from animals that evolved to go back into the ocean from land, but at the same time, we have octopuses and squid, which can be very intelligent but haven't built any rockets yet. But if ocean life did evolve intelligence and some kind of civilization on an ocean world, there may be little way for them to make that civilization technological. You need a suitable environment to create technology, and water is by no means ideal, but it may go deeper than that. If our solar system is any indicator, most ocean worlds are not located within the habitable zones of their stars. These environments are the ice shell moons like Europa and Enceladus, and quite a few others within the solar system. While it's by no means clear if these places can harbor complex life, there may be factors that keep life in these waters microbial. If such a place could evolve an intelligent species, though, then that species not only may never become technological, they may never even know there's a universe outside their ocean. Rather, the universe as they saw it would end at a giant wall of ice. Perhaps someday, we'll drop by and rescue them. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently envious of ocean life. One line of thinking is that the reason that ocean life doesn't usually develop intelligence is because they have it too easy and it's simply not needed. Look at a clam. All it needs to do is sit there and filter to get by, at least until the humans have a clam bake. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.